Thanks. Not really trying to speed run it or anything, just doing a casual playthrough. I played through this fairly recently, so I remember where most everything is. I kind of remember where to go. Thank you. you say infestation, I say they're my girls, so what can I say? Tomato, tomato. Too complacent. Thank you. Those are Alpha Metroids. The whole this is basically a remake of Metroid 2, if you haven't figured it out by now. The whole storyline of this game, which originally came out for the Game Boy, is you're on the Metroid's home planet of SR388, and basically your objective is to wipe them out, but they're mutating. So this is only a demo. The full version's not complete yet, but so we're only going to see 2 out of the 5 total mutations in the game. But as you can definitely tell, I mean, the guy that's doing this is very talented. I mean, this is a really well done game. So everything I've been fighting so far are Alpha Metroids, and later on we'll come across Gamma Metroids. I just recently discovered this myself. Apparently this demo's been out, this game's been out for a while, at least in demo format. Like I said, it's not It's not complete, but there's a there's also a tech demo that the guy did that was released as kind of a standalone game called Metroid Confrontation, which has kind of a storyline associated with it, but really, like I said, what it was it was designed as a tech demo for this game. But it includes a couple boss fights, very similar play control, also a custom soundtrack. And that's one thing I really love about this game is the soundtrack. I mean, if you can listen to the music here in the Hydro Station, this is like my favorite song in this game. I've listened to this constantly. Because I always loved the original Brinstar music from Super Metroid. And this is a remake of it. Oh yeah, yeah. He definitely did a lot of work. And there's actually some hope because Nintendo has shown in the past that if they are impressed by certain indie games. They'll release them. So there's actually a lot of hope that they'd be that Nintendo will notice this and release it on the Virtual Console once it's complete. And I really can't think of a reason why they shouldn't. I mean, this is. I'm actually really excited to see some of the new stuff coming out because, like I said, this game's about 3/4 of the way through. There's out of the four major ruins areas, like the Golden Temple, the Hydro Station, things like that. Out of the four major ones, he's done three so far. This is so like I said, he's actually not that far from completing it. It's pretty close, but. So we'll see how that plays out. Mini boss time. I also like some of the little minor gameplay changes, like the if you come across like a one block platform like that, you automatically will climb up it, or there's a couple other changes. I can't really think of any off the top of my head. he also adds in some stuff that wasn't in the original game. Like later on, I'll get the speed booster. There's a demo video that he came out with showing the gravity suit, the plasma, or not the plasma beam, plasma beam was originally in this, but power bombs. So a lot of stuff that wasn't in the original Metroid 2 is going to be added in, is going to be added into it. And I like how this works. There's actual physics in the game to where it's like if you get close to it, you'll actually get sucked in. Yeah, kind of going back to the Metroid evolution cycle. If you remember the end of Fusion, the final boss was an Omega Metroid. This game, Metroid 2, is where they originally debuted. I do believe that is it for Al. Stupid screen shut off. That is it for here. Now on to the breeding grounds. What's up, Banji? That's not fair. Thank you. This one's a lot more aggressive. It's also a lot more defensive too. Now we get our first look at a gamma. I'm not sure exactly how many alphas are in the game total. The little Metroid counter at the top right only tells me how many are in this area. And I'm missing one. I think I have an idea where he is, but... Why I keep falling off there. Oh yeah, I remember now. There is one more that I missed because he's right up here. Really? Knock it off. There you are. get the next earthquake. Which gives us access to the next area. First. Actually, I just realized there's an item that I missed. Well, I'm using the spider ball, so it's like I shouldn't be falling off unless I use a bomb. That's what's throwing me off here. It's just weird, I've never seen it do that before. Actually, two that I missed. Yeah, like I said, I don't really know what caused it. Like I said, in using the spider ball, it's like the only thing that should knock me off is either getting hit or using one of my own bombs, but neither of that happens, so I don't know. Gotta go up and around. Thank you. There we go. Now I can leave. This leads us to the industrial area. If you've ever played Metroid Prime 2 Echoes, you'd recognize the music. Yep, that was another thing, another new thing that was added. Another new addition that was not in the original game. Almost didn't expect to pull that off. Shine Spark puzzles are always always kind of a bane of my existence. I hate these things with a passion. They weren't nearly as annoying in the original game. Just yet. See, the funny part is, it's like, that one had longer legs than a normal alpha. I'm kind of curious if the guy that did this programmed into the game to where, if you don't encounter him quickly enough, like, if, say, I waited till, like, the end of this area to run into him, I wonder if he might have evolved into a gamma. Instead of an alpha. I think it'd be kind of a cool touch. Now you see what I was talking about when I said I hated those guys. Horizontal shine sparks have always been kind of a bane of my existence. Especially trying to do them on command. Like that. There's something down there. I think it's a super missile tank. But I have no clue how to get to it. That's gotta be it right there. I keep thinking that this is something up here, but... yeah, nothing. Kind of a fun little puzzle here. Control these little guys. There's one down. Two down. Yeah, it's kind of weird. Later, Andy. And now we have super missiles. Now I know from watching a playthrough of this that there is there's another beam in this area, but I can't think of where it could be. See this here. First time I played through this, I actually missed this completely. Thank you. Yeah, gammas now have a new attack where they can charge me and either knock me over or grab me.
Thank you.
never saw that before. Remains of the research team. And that's the end of the demo. 95%, so I knew that I missed something. Well, straightforward, so that's it. I gotta get guys, so catch you later.